Hello, and welcome back to Crusader Kings 2. when we last played, we had a bunch of things happen. Duke Ansem got some heirs. Well, at least one heir. He's got another one potentially on the way. We'll see what happens. West Francia is currently in a revolt, as you can see right here. And that's over, like, elective succession. So let's get into the game. We are still in control of the Duchy of Holland and the Duchy of Brabant. Okay, here we go. game is paused. It's February 1st, 771. So, I think we are set to go. I don't think there's anything special that we need to do right now. I want to talk a little bit about this Chancellor fabricating claims. Whenever you want to take over territory, you need a claim on it. And actually, whenever you go to war, you need a reason for it. You can't just invade somebody's territory. And so, what we need to do is we need to fabricate claims on Loon before we can take it over. Once we have a claim on it, then we can go in and say, okay, this is really ours. Here's the claim. We're going to war. We're going to take you over. But before we have that claim, we can't actually go into Loon and take it over. So, just for clarification. Okay, so we will get this going. And let's have it going at, like, double speed. It's not really double speed, but a little bit faster than normal. So you'll notice there's fighting over here. These are between two groups that we're not involved in. That's why it's gray. Up, and there's a daughter, Festrada. So Festrada has been born to Duke Ansem and Princess Anselperga. Okay. And he's fulfilled the ambition. So we gotta pick a new one. Let's hit the space bar. Let's go pick an ambition. Now, what are we going to do? Well, it'd be really cool if we became... Let's see which one, the steward. I think I would make a great steward. So let's do that. I don't really want to have this guy say that he wants to become the King of Frisia, only because there's no way that he is actually going to make it. So anyway, alright, so that's that. He's 51 years old. He may live for another 10 years. He may live for another, 20 years. Okay, so the Duke of Flanders has usurped the county of Guignes, which is right here. So he basically took it over. Flanders is getting large, so we have to be careful of that. We definitely want to take over Loon when we get the chance. So that guy just got defeated over there. there's a huge battle going on over here between the West Francian army and the army of the West Francian revolt, and also the Middle Francian army just showed up too, so... So King Carl has inherited the county of Anjou from Count Hildegard. That's because Hildegard didn't have any heirs. A noble has distinguished himself in this battle. Perhaps I can make use of him. So a soldier named Markomer has appeared in the court of Duke Anselm. Okay, so what does that exactly mean? If I go in here, there's, is it Markomer? Oh, there he is, Markomer. we'll deal with this in just a second. But this guy just showed up. He's a soldier, sort of noble guy. So here he is. So he's now part of our court too. And this is his opinion of us. So that's a good thing. We may make use of him in the future. Meanwhile, let's look at this. My liege, the construction work being done in Holland is coming along well under the meticulous eyes of a master builder. This is the bonus for the steward overseeing construction. So we say excellent. So that makes it go even faster. See, this little hammer and the bar indicate that something's being built in there. So, this is all good news. Switches back to terrain. Okay, so currently right now, West Francia is winning the revolt. Okay, so the militia training ground has been built. That means that we can take our counselor, the steward guy, and we can do something else with him. Oh! Ludegardus has exposed an affair between my wife and the Prince Bishop Wormaid of Trier. This is the same guy who had the child out of wedlock. Anselberg is now known as the Unfaithful. Alright, so let's deal with this first. So, we're going to have this guy collect taxes in Holland. Now, once this popped up, and actually I think this is part of way of life now, this has popped up, which indicates that we can imprison people without incurring tyranny. I actually have... this may sound a little callous. but I already, the heirs are already here. See, these heirs are already here. So, technically speaking, I could throw her in prison. Faithful harlot. Okay, so, adulteress. So general opinion is down. This is the reason why I can imprison her without a problem, without an issue. So, let's go and do that. Since Princess Anselberg has acted dishonorably towards you, no one will care. And now she's locked away in the dungeon. Now here's another thing, and I've never had reason to do this before, but you could also request a divorce. Due to her unfaithfulness, this request will not be denied and will cost nothing. However, it will be viewed as an insult by her relatives. Yeah, see, they've actually added this into the game in Way of Life. You can also... Yeah, see, that one is not possible, but this one is. And I'm not sure that... I could also execute her, too. Since you have a valid reason, no one will care. And it costs me 20 piety. I can also banish her from the realm. I don't know. Let's do that. And then maybe we'll banish her from the realm. Okay. Now... oh yes, our domain is too big again, because we... we are no longer married to her, so we no longer get her bonus. Okay, so we can no longer banish. Oh, right, we can't banish her anymore. We can ransom her back to her father. So let's do that. And then, okay, so that's done. Okay, let me pause here. Is there another eligible spouse to look for here? Okay, so let's take a look at what we got since the last one. Last one didn't work out too well. Actually, the last one gave us two heirs. let's see what we got. We're 51 years old, so we really can't wait around for kids to grow up. So, let's look here. A valet. Oh no, that's too far away. Mantua is down here. Here's Faults again. County of Faults. But Faults is under a duchy, so that doesn't really help any. Here's 15, I only have to wait 1 year, but... And of course, you know, this is always the issue, is that you've got a 51-year-old man who's basically going to be marrying, you know, 18-year-olds, which is, you know, ridiculous, but this is sort of how it's done. So, you know, in this time period, this is, I don't know if this guy is, I don't know if this guy is his own realm. Yes, he is. Colm is its own realm. So that would actually be good. We could strike up an alliance. And sadly, this is the only way that you can make alliances, too. You know, that you can make alliances. it's just a courtier, so there's no alliance with it. So I don't think there's any I don't think there are any that there are any useful or advantageous potential spouses out there. So I'm just going to leave it alone. If there was a somewhere where we could make an alliance that would be useful, that would be okay. I'm not really too worried about this right now. Let's check our intrigue for our known plots. Oh, this is still here. This plot power has gone up a little bit. 56.6. And that's 45.5. Okay. So, one of the things that we could do is we could give somebody else a territory. Like Henault or something. Where's Alf? Alf is in Henault. We could give that military soldier guy Henault to run. I can't really think of it. It would just keep this down. That's the only real issue. It would be 5 of 5 then, but I don't know. Anyway, let's keep going. I can check and see how people feel about me. Oh, not a problem. See, it says domain too big, negative 10, but it's still tapped out at 100, so I'm not too worried about that. Okay. So, continuing onwards, we're still waiting for Loon to get, for us to get a claim on Loon. We got 398 gold. So, oh, okay, so the old pope has died, and now there's a new pope. If I want to look at religion stuff, here's all the stuff for the religion that this guy follows. Here's my guy. These are my vassal bishops. And this guy is like an archbishop. He's a prince bishop. There is a the College of Cardinals. And here's the list of them. So here's the pope. Here is the expected guy who's going to be the next pope. And then these are all the guys in the Cardinals College, and this is who they're voting for. Here's my best cardinal candidate, and here's the next expected cardinal. And I can throw money at this in order to make his cardinal appointment score go up. I haven't really ever delved into this yet. But right now I just want to build up the kingdom here, the duchy. So let's do that again. We've got 415 gold. Let's build something else. I can build a barracks, which would give me even more troops. So let's do that. Once again, I'm going to take my guy, and on February 8th, I'm going to change him over to oversee construction again. I am pretty sure that if he revokes the county of Brabant, I think he's revoking the duchy of Brabant too. Oh, we have another guy. Oh, this guy. Where is this guy? Where is this guy? This guy's down there. This is the guy who, and he's actually my rival. If I go into relations, here he is. So this guy and Duke Anselm hate each other. Now I only have one. Oh yeah, I still have, yeah, I got the one ally. So yeah, wow, okay. So if I go back into intrigue, what is this up to now? 61%. Let me go talk to this guy and say stop backing plot. Oh, wow. So really, he really is not going to want to. Political concerns versus King Carl, political concerns versus Duke Anselm. Yeah, we may have a problem. He may actually take that from us. So this is the guy, huh? Let's see what allies this guy has. He's got nothing. He has nothing as far as allies go, and he's got 300 guys. I'm almost tempted to move this guy down there. But then, of course, you know, I'd have the duchy up here, and the duchy over here, and then I'd have this sort of breakaway province down here. He's 30. And he's heir to the Duchy of Flanders. Holy jeez. Wow. He doesn't have any heirs either. Revoke the title of the County of Brabant. Yeah, I can't imagine that would also not include the duchy, but we'll see what happens. Right now, there's Thuringia again. Which is these two, I think. Uh, ruins right here. That's the Countess of Ypres. That's interesting. I mean, you'd have to live for 15 years in order to actually make that marriage happen, but... And I don't know if... I don't know what would happen from that. Like, if that becomes part of my territory or not. As part of, like, the duchy or something. Of something. Right now... See, Courtier of Calm... Envious, proud, content, greedy, wroth, administrator, and a thrifty clerk. That's a lot. But that's actually a really good, pretty good, score for, stewardship, and that would increase this. And that would get rid of that problem. So... Yeah, see, but I lose 200 for marrying a courtier, so... That's, Nah, forget it. Forget it, let's just leave it alone. Let's keep going. Okay, now you'll notice, right here... Whoops. Let's switch this over to oversee construction in Holland. Okay. So you'll notice that the Army of West Francia is sieging right here. This is Amiens, I think, yeah. So they're sieging in here. And so far they're winning. So this is a good example right here. They're showing you how much the occupations work to help the score. They also show all different battles and how much... Oh. And how much they affected. And... The longer that King Carl controls West Francia, the more that bonus is going to go up. Because basically the rebels have basically said, okay, well, we're going to take over, and they haven't yet. So, that war should be over pretty soon. But this is interesting. King Carl has created the title the Duchy of Gelre. You know what? I'm really not appreciating this, I just paused the game, too. So, I'm really not appreciating this, that the king is trying to just revoke this away from me. Don't like that at all. So... thrown with the independence faction. Since that way, at the very least, I will be independent. the other people in the Independence faction? Dax? And Gascon. I think those guys are on the other side of... Those guys are down here. Dax... Yeah, Dax is all the way down there. And, the other one... Go back to factions. The other one is this guy. And he is... right here. So this whole area right here would go independent. And us. So this whole region right here. This whole region right here. But really, if that happens, then if I want to go and take Loon, for instance, I would have to be taking on the entire kingdom. I don't know how I feel about that. Let me think on that a little more. You know what I want to do? I'm sick of this guy. Possible plot power 55%. Wow. Let's see what this looks like. Okay, so here's how this works. I basically set up a plot. Okay, and my plot is I'm going to kill this guy off. So here's how this works. It shows me the target. Okay. It shows me the plot power, which, as a plot gains strength by having backers, the plot power increases. So, and then I can use this to go look for backers. If I click this button, I auto-invite people who would normally join my plot. But I want to take a look at this. Okay. So here's the way this works. I've got all these people, okay, who potentially could join the plot because they're close enough to this guy that they could affect the plot. Okay. So, thumbs up means that he's willing to join the plot. Okay, so invite to plot. Yes, yes, okay. So we invited that guy. The percentages show how much plot power they're going to add to this score. Okay, so here we go, ready? See this guy right here? This guy might be persuaded with a bag of gold. Okay, so let's send him a gift of 20 gold, increases his opinion of me by 53. So I'm basically going to bribe him. So, and then I'm going to go invite to plot. Now he says yes. So send. Okay, I'm going to close this. Okay, there are the two people that we are asking to back. This guy was all for it. So now we're at 93.8. That's pretty strong. Okay. That's all I'm really going to need for this. That's really all I'm going to need for this. Okay, and then, with certain plots, as you get up in plot power, you get more decisions up here. You have a plot to, if you have a plot to to like revoke something. When you get over 75%, you get an option. When you get over 150 or 100, you get an option. So, okay. Whoa, what is this? Oh, there's a Slavic uprising. The West Francine Slavic Revolt on King Carl. Okay, so these guys right here are part of the Slavic uprising. Okay, and basically what that means is that if I look at this territory, see, the religion is Slavic. They're under a Catholic ruler's control, but the religion is Slavic, and the culture is Pomeranian. So their warriors of faith have basically started up a revolt here. Okay, so the barracks have been completed. Oh! Lords of West Francia have approved the institution of the limited crown authority. So, let's take a look at what limited crown authority does. That's right here. Okay? That increases the number of levies. And this guy has automatically founded the lower crown authority in West Francia faction. Okay. Let's go back here. I don't think I can change another one till 774. I can change this to agnatic if I really want to. That would mean only men can inherit. But, I think I'm going to leave it the way it is. Oh. I could actually set this up to be succession by ultimogeniture. Ultimogeniture is that the youngest child inherits. Primogeniture is the oldest child inherits. Unfortunately, I can't do that because the Kingdom of Francia has to have either high or absolute crown authority to do that. But I can do it here. Right now, I don't need this to happen. Oh, fantastic. So, Baron Hildevold, this guy, has sent word that the carriage is going to suffer an unfortunate accident, leaving no survivors. So, we approve of the plan. Now, it's quite possible that this guy is going to get killed, and it's going to get traced back to us, which might happen. It's also possible that he'll get killed and it won't get traced back to us. So we'll see what happens. Right now we've got two wars going on. One of them is a Middle Francian revolt that we are that we're allies with, and we're also defending against the uprising. Shame on such a nice carriage, though. So, the carriage was flying over the edge of the cliff with this guy in it. That guy's taken care of. We no longer have a problem. This has gone down to back down to 52%, which is nice. Using your foot as leverage, you pull your sword out of the dead corpse. All around you, men are cheering at the routing enemies. Victory is achieved in part because of your heroic efforts. Gain 100 prestige. Okay. Let's build something else in Holland. Once more. Let's increase the keep size. Do we want to do that? Let's increase the castle fortifications for right now. That's cheap and that goes fast. Okay, so apparently this guy got captured and then he got released. He probably got released because they paid a ransom. And, as you can see, that revolt is gone. The Middle Francian That would be this. Whenever you see the red and black, this is a revolt. It's always the revolt colors. So, King Carl has revoked the county, the Duchy of Aquitaine. Wow. This guy is consolidating a lot of duchies under him. Normandy, Galray. Oh, he must have given it to somebody else. Okay, let's pause just for a second because we got another message. I should invest in a technological advance. Okay, so here we go. This is the technology screen. You can only invest in technologies in your capital. Okay, so it says advancements in your capital province of Holland. Now I could check. Here's the advancements in Breda. Here's the advancements in Sticht. Here's the advancements in Zeeland. I can check. I can check the technological status. But the technologies will be invested in Holland and then spread to surrounding territories. That's very important because some of the stuff that your council does is increase the spread of the technology rate for either military, economy, or culture. Right now it's basically telling me that I have enough that I can invest in any one of the military advances. So, what can we do? What does this do? Increases the morale of armies, increases the global supply limit so that I don't have attrition, and 150% retinues. That's okay. Shipbuilding, I can unlock shipbuilding so that I can make ships. That's actually probably a pretty good one. Here's siege equipment. So siege speed and defense is better. Here's cavalry. This increases cavalry attack and defense. Same thing with heavy infantry and light infantry. These are almost done. You'll see these cogs are moving. That indicates that... These advancements are working towards filling the block, basically. So I think I'm going to do shipbuilding. Okay, now I did shipbuilding, and I still have enough points left over to finish up light infantry, so I'm going to do that too. Okay. This is how you advance your technology, by the way. So with that in mind, we just did castle fortifications, and they're almost halfway done. Once we're done with that, then we could do the castle shipyard, and then we could start building boats. In this game, boats are just simple galleys, so you can't actually attack fleets. They're simply used to transport armies. And one boat transports 100 guys, so... Okay, let's check on our intrigue, and the plot power is dropping. What I'm wondering is, if I right click on this guy and say stop backing plot, right, this one, how far is that? Yeah, that's really, really, part of the problem is when the king tells you, hey, back my plot, it's kind of hard to say no, because then you'll piss him off, and he's in a worse position than I am, so. Anyway, so let's go back into Holland, and let's build this castle shipyard. We still have the steward overseeing construction, so it's going to go pretty fast. Once we do that, then we can build fleets. Okay, domain, ruler's still unmarried. How old is this guy now? He's 53. Can I switch my focus? I can switch my focus. So I'm going to switch my focus to rulership, which will increase my stewardship by 3. Your current focus cannot be canceled. Oh, I gotta wait until 774. Okay. So let's do that. Yeah, that's not really helping me right now. It is, but it isn't. This guy has been, he had been captured, and so they just ransomed him off. So now I'm just waiting for this. Okay. So our levy reinforcement rate just went down because this guy got in the way. Well, that's unfortunate, but... So we're waiting for this to January 1st, 774. When we increase the... when we increase our stewardship, it will help this domain size. So we'll be back in the black, as they say. I think also when 774 comes up, we can... Oh, okay. So let's pause. Oh, we're auto-saving anyway. Okay, so it's paused. So let's go into here. We'll switch this to rulership. Let's say select. It used to be that when you clicked on this, become steward, when you clicked on the ambition, that you had ambitions that would say improve my stewardship or improve my diplomacy if they were lower than 8. But now they don't do that. Now that part of it is taken over with your focus, which is what you're focusing on. So, okay. So that's done. Let's check our laws again. Here's our laws. It's January 25th. Okay. So when January 25th comes rolling around, I can change, like, centralization to medium too, if I want to, or any other ones of these. Okay, so now, because of that, we're up to domain size 6 of 6, which is good. We're still okay. He's still the heir. He's going to inherit everything. She's the first pretender, but she's not going to inherit. She's not going to inherit any of this stuff yet, unless something happens to him. Okay, so you'll notice this just popped because it's after January 28th. So. I can't actually... select this because I need a legalism level of at least 2. Oops, sorry about that. I hit the microphone. Legalism isn't technology, that's right down here. The shipyard has been built. Okay, let's pause just for a second. Let's get back to our council. We want our steward to collect taxes in Holland now. We gotta pay for all this stuff now. Okay, so I'm surprised we haven't gotten this yet. It's almost about 20% a year, so okay. So here's Holland. Now if I go and look at my military, the nice part is that I don't actually have to build the ships. The ships get built, and the crews get hired automatically. Same thing with the army levies. I have a total of 2033 that I can have from my domain, and I've got 1687, which is pretty good. The reason why there's a difference in these is because I just built up a whole bunch of stuff, like the keep, and the barracks and the militia training grounds. So I'm still working on recruiting guys here. So that's that. Let's check this again. How are we doing? 49. That's pretty lame. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Okay. Let's take a look around. We want to take Loon, but Liege is part of the Duchy of Luxembourg. Who is the head of? Oh, my half-brother is the Duke of Luxembourg now. Okay. Who's the Duke of Gelre? Guess who's the Duke of Gelre? That would be King Carl. He hasn't given that up to anybody yet. Okay. Köln is still independent. Yeah, that's still independent. How do I know that? If I click on the Prince Bishopric of Köln. Okay, so I click on the little shield. Right. If it was under a duchy, there would be a little duchy shield here. I'll give you an example. So here's Holland, right? If I click on it, this is the county of Holland. This is the Duchy of Holland. So this is the county. This is the duchy. And that's all part of the kingdom. And if the kingdom was part of a empire, it would appear up here. If I click on de jure, okay, these are like the traditional geographic areas. The Kingdom of West Francia will be in an empire called Francia, which would be all the Francias, basically. So let's take off de jure. This is de facto. This is what it is. So then these are all the independent vassals. Okay. let's continue. We're not going to build anything anymore for a little while. We want our wealth to go up again. The reason why I'm building up Holland is because that's the least likely territory to get taken over. Here's a boat. And I'm willing to bet that that boat is actually a levy that I gave to the king. Oh, there's never been a shortage of soldiers reinforcing the troops, so our levy reinforcement rate in Holland went up by 50%. Which is kind of nice. So, it's down by 200, and it's up by 50. Eh. I think that might even itself out. That expires on May 13th, so it's going to be done pretty soon. This one expires on April 21st of next year. Yeah, so if I click right here, it should already be expired, but, okay. Alright, let's take a look at our military. Yeah, that's getting nice. Ruler is still unmarried. Yeah, I don't really know how I feel about that exactly. She is almost of age. Franconia. Well, so yeah, so Karnev is over here. It's independent though, so it won't be able to help me. I really need, you know, if Thuringia, if this happens to get the 16 and, you know, she's not married off, maybe, but I don't know. We've eliminated my rival, so that's kind of nice. This guy over here. Oh, look. Well, I think that focus is much better than the last guy's. Okay. Let's check our intrigue again. Still pretty much the same. Hey, here's a question. Ooh. You know what? I'm the heir to the Duchy of Luxembourg. Really? I'm the heir to the Duchy of Luxembourg, not his brother, huh? Oh, wow. Once controlled the County of Loon. Yeah. Wait a minute. Here's Loon. Okay, let's pause just for a moment after the autosave. And let's deal with one more thing. You know, that plot worked out really, really well in knocking off that guy. And what I'm wondering is, here's the autosave. What I'm wondering is, guy's trying to kill my half-brother. He's the heir to the county of Jülich. But he's the duke. What happens if I think about this? I mean, he's my half-brother, after all. Right? He's also plotting... He's helping King Carl to try to get the county of Braven. It's really kind of crappy. So, let's see what we got going here. Let's see what we've got. Okay. We've got a couple of people who can help us with this. 15% and 17%, but the rest of them... Gosh, I would really love this guy. But... Yeah, he's unwilling to join the plot because he likes the liege too much. He does want to get married, though. Yeah, see, these guys are close enough that we could persuade them with a bag of gold, but I think those are the only two. So we've got 15 and 17%, that's, 32%? 32 plus 40? 32 plus 46 is almost 80. That's not bad, that's pretty good. It'd be nice if we could get that guy, though. I don't think we're going to beat that opinion, though, unfortunately. I can sort these guys by plot power. So here's the mayor. Yeah, see, all these people really like the duke. This guy has moral qualms. That guy has moral qualms. Okay, so... Wow, I could grab these two guys, which is... That's not bad. So let's try this. Ready? Let's send a gift. And let's send a gift. Okay. Now, if I look at these guys are green. So invite there. And invite there. Okay. Let's see how this works out. Oh, that didn't take very long at all. Of course, if I get caught doing this, it's going to be a little bit of a problem. But I'll tell you what we want to do. I think we want to... Let's go back to that screen one more time. We'll let this roll. I want to look at this guy because I want to arrange a marriage for him. Oh, fantastical. Okay. So now... There we go. See, this guy wanted to get married. So now, he's married. Ta-da! It's called fulfilling ambitions. If you fill people's ambitions, they like you better. See, right now... Ta-da! Okay, so, if I go like this... Let's go into intrigue now. I don't think that's going to put him on... Oh! Did she not? Oh! Okay, so... The person we just put into his court... We can also help. That was kind of sneaky. Okay, so now we're at 72.9%, which is way better than 49 and 45. So we'll have that run for a little bit. If that actually works, then okay, and we're back. Just as I paused, this dialog box popped up, which is basically the fall of the Avars. And basically, it talks about how the Avar Khaganate, had been established, and now, instead of the Avar Dynasty, it's going to be called Pannonia. So Avar is gone, Pannonia is in. So, and then I think we're gonna stop the game here. Let me pause. One of our guys, I think, died. Yeah, the steward, I think. Died, or it probably. So let's install the steward. Let's install this guy, and we'll have him collect taxes. And then we're gonna stop here. This is a long enough video, I think. And thank you for watching. Hopefully, you had fun. I didn't expect to be as intriguing as I've been, but you know, every game is a little different. So hope to see you next time, and that's it.